Well, fragrance we're talking about today actually won the most votes on the poll that I put on my channel page under a community post. Of course, it's one of the newer releases from Montal. It's called Oud Tobacco. Stay tuned. So we'll start off with the presentation. I do have a tester box in metallic red. It says Oud Tobacco Eau de Parfum, size and concentration. Shows it's a tester. Montal has some numbers on top. Fragrance information on the back and the side. Nothing really going on the bottom. And then in regards to this bottle, this is one of the best looking ones that I have. It's straight up mirrored red metallic with gold indices and logos. And it is a tester, so the pin goes through the atomizer, so the pin's always there for show. It's not, doesn't actually remove it. It just sprays. Let's get into this scent. So this might sound a little strange to you guys. I'll have the notes on screen. But immediately, the first thing I think of, it doesn't go away for several hours, actually. It's easier for me to tell you what I get this way. Think of a Flintstone vitamin. I know. I said a Flintstone vitamin. Think back to when you were a kid and you used to eat Flintstone vitamins. Remember that specific medicinal, just medicine smell? Flintstone vitamins in a bottle. Yeah. It's a very, very mild tobacco. There's a nice tonka bean sweetness. There's this strange kind of spicy smokiness that lends itself almost like a grape Flintstone vitamin because of how medicinal the oud is. The way all of that mixes together, that slight little bit of citruses that's in here. And look, it doesn't drastically change. The Flintstones vitamin smell, I know that sounds funny for me to say that, does start to tone down over time. And the tobacco and tonka bean really take over later on. But for the first several hours, I don't find it to be real tobacco dominant. I was kind of surprised, but the oud here is some of the most medicinal oud I've ever smelled. My wife's first thought was Robitussin, and then when I said Flintstone vitamins, she hit me with the, yes, that's exactly what it is, wide-eyed and everything, because it's very distinct to me. I don't know how many of you have smelled this or tried this, but it's that, that's the scent memory I have tied to this scent profile that I get for the first, I would say, 2 to 3 hours. It smells like Flintstone vitamins. And I don't say that in a bad way. I actually quite enjoy this. I've been spending some time with it. Been spraying it every night on my arm. I actually just did a full wearing yesterday. And does it fill a room? No. Is it long lasting? Absolutely. But when I say it doesn't fill a room, that doesn't mean it's weak off the skin either. There's a really nice sillage, nice little scent bubble going. It's a moderate level projector where, you know, people walking by you, you walking by people specifically, should be able to get a whiff of you. But like I said, definitely not a room filler. I wouldn't consider this a beast mode fragrance because its projection is not heavy. It's on the moderate side, moderate to moderate heavy, slightly below what I would consider gets close to a beast mode type of projector, but it's definitely got beast mode longevity. I'm looking at about 10 hours on my skin as what I've been averaging, and it's actually quite unique in my collection. When I first saw the name and the color, I immediately thought Mancera Red Tobacco, and I gotta tell you, smells absolutely nothing like Mancera Red Tobacco. So if you had that worry, have no fear. It smells nothing like that. If you have red tobacco and you are interested in this one, by all means, it does not smell anything close. There's zero redundancy here based on my nose, in my opinion. And is it blind buy safe? I would say no, because if you don't like medicinal oud, then you probably won't like this. If you're not sure if you like medicinal oud, I would definitely sample it first. But definitely a must try, in my opinion, just for the pure curiosity of me saying, smells like Flintstone vitamins. That's got to intrigue you, whether good, bad, or indifferent. But it definitely does. It's a very medicinal oud, a very mild tobacco with a slight citrus, tonka bean powdery sweetness, and this strange, I forgot what to, you call it, starts with an S. It's some type of spice that's in there that I've never heard of before. I don't distinguish a specific type of spice. It just has a warm spice to it. But not heavily nuanced, yet not extremely linear either. It's kind of falls somewhere in between that, where it does slightly change over time, but not drastically change. Again, I think it's very good. There's a link down below. If you want to check it out, get a sample, or go ahead and get yourself a bottle from Twisted Lily. And yeah, definitely going to be wearing this one a lot more. Very, very different. Of course, once again, we were talking about Oud Tobacco from Montal. Well, that's my thoughts and opinions on Oud Tobacco from Montal. And until next time, do me a real quick favor. Go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, because I do appreciate all the feedback, and I love hearing from you guys. Maybe you've tried this already. It's not what I expected it to be. It's different, but it's good different. I'm digging the scent profile. I really am. It doesn't smell like any other Oud or tobacco or Oud tobacco fragrance that I have in my collection. It definitely, anytime I can bring in something to the collection that's got a uniqueness within what I already have, definitely makes me happy, and I always put that in the win column. And until next time, I will say, if you get your hands on Oud Tobacco from Montal and you give it a spray now, you might end up thanking me later. Have a good one, guys.